Good morning, students. In the previous video, I have tried to give introduction and a short summary of the lesson 1, the invention of the shoes. And I am quite confident that all of you might have listened the video and have learned something. Today I will explain the story line by line so that it will be more clear for you. You will understand better. So you can see your book. Once upon a time, there was a king called Hobu. So many years back, there was a king named Hobu. One morning, he summoned his minister and said, "Listen, Goburai, I stayed up all night thinking." So, one early morning, he calls his minister and ordered him and tells him to listen to him. He says that he could not sleep all night. He was thinking, he was worried about something. What was that matter? Let us see further. "Why should the dust dirty my royal feet whenever I step on the ground?" So he was worried about his feet. King was thinking that he's something great, and actually he was a great man. That is why he was thinking that his feet should not be dirty whenever he goes out, and that bothered him and he could not sleep all night. He was trying to solve this problem. He was trying to find out the solution, how to solve this problem, that his leg or his feet whenever goes out should not become dirty. He calls his minister and tells about this matter. "All you people, you are only concerned with pocketing your fat salaries." He tells the minister that these people are not bothered about the problem of the king, but they are only worried about their salaries. They were getting a lot of salaries and they were only worried about salaries. "You have no concern for the king or the kingdom or the problems that bother me." So king says that these people are not worried or not concerned about the problems of the king or kingdom that bothers him. That is why he strongly summoned him that if they don't solve this problem, king will not leave them without punishment. "You must put an end to this at once." So king strongly gave message that if they do not solve this problem immediately, they will have to face the consequence, or else no one shall be spared from my royal wrath. So king says that if they don't solve this problem, that he will be, then he will be very angry. And whoever it is, those who are belong to that palace, all will suffer and punished by king. Gobu Rai wondered and worried. He pondered and perspired. So Gobu Rai, after listening to the king and his warning, he was so much worried, so much surprised, and he was thinking so deeply. He was pondering over how to solve the problem of the king, and if they don't solve the problem of the king, they are going to be punished surely. And all these things were going in his mind. That is why he started sweating. Water started flowing over his body. The Pandit's faces turned pale. Pandit means the expert person who give opinion to the people, who advise people. Their faces became sad and worried. The courteous knights turned sleepless. The courteous means the advisors of the king, those people who are highly intelligent. They advise the king how to rule the kingdom. So their night also became sleepless. They were not sleeping because of the fear. In the kitchen, the cooking stopped. Even they stopped cooking. In the castle, the crying started. So all the people, Pandit, minister, courtiers, everybody was worried about how to solve this problem. And if they don't solve this problem, they are going to be punished. That is why their life became very miserable. And all started crying. What is going to happen in the future? Gobu Rai looked far and wide and gathered all the scientists and learned men, all the scholars and mechanics he could find. So Gobu Rai was a visionary man. He could see things, what is going to happen in the future, what will be the consequence if they don't solve the problem. That is why whatever possibility is there, he goes all around the kingdom and tries to gather all the highly intellectual people so that it will be easy for them to solve this problem. That is why he goes round and round and calls all the scientists learned men. Learned men means very intelligent. Scholars also very intelligent, and mechanics, you know what are the things they make. So he, whomever he finds, he gathers all of them. They pushed their glasses up their noses and sat down to find a solution to the royal problem. So all these learned men, all intelligent people, scientists, learned men, scholars and mechanics, and minister, all of them together, they sat and they started to think. They are breaking their heads how to solve this royal problem. They are putting their glass up to the noses and started thinking. After thinking long and deep, they said, so they discussed after long thinking, what they say. If you do away with the soil, how will you grow crops? So after thinking, negotiation, discussion and deliberations, they go to the king and they say that if we remove the soil, then how will you grow crops and how the people will survive in the kingdom? The king replied, if you cannot figure out how, then of what use are you? In reply, the king put all these people in all the difficult situation. He's questioning about their qualification, about their identity. He's telling that if you cannot make out after removing the soil how you will grow the crops, then what kind of scientists or scholars or learned men you are, then you are of no use. That is what he says. So for today, I think it is enough. I hope you will understand something or the other. So, thank you.